Today we'll be learning about the most important topic, which we call as a fundamental unit of life. So when the name only suggests, what is a fundamental unit of life? Life means we see different types of living organisms in our surroundings, plants, animals, birds. So when you look at them, we see that they are made up of different types of organs, and these organs are made up of different type of tissues. About tissues you will be learning in the further topics. And next, these group of tissues are made up of small units we call as a cell. So this cell, it will control all the activities of the living organisms. It may be respiration and transportation of the essential materials. So those all activities are taking place in the living organism are controlled by the cell. And this cell was first of all discovered by a scientist named Robert Hooke in the year 1665, when he was observing about the handmade lens of his own. He was observing the reed bark. He found a small jelly-like materials like honeycomb-like structures. So each structure of this comb he named as it as a small rooms. And each small room he called it as a cell, because it contained some kind of a life in that. So that cell, it was first discovered by a scientist called Robert Hooke in the year 1665. Later, he was observed by using the tree bark, means the dead part of the plant, a wooden bark, in that he observed these structures. And in these structures, about each part of that structure, he named it as a cell. And later, in the year 1674, the scientist Antony von Leeuwenhoek, he found different small minute living organisms, which are very minute microscopic organisms. When he was studying about the pond water, he found different organisms, and those organisms he named as a microorganism, like amoeba. He observed like these structures. And these are the examples of microorganisms which was discovered by scientist Antony von Leeuwenhoek. Later in the year 1831, another scientist came who named Robert Brown. He introduced a main component of the cell, and that cell it will be present in cell that is called as nucleus, which is the brain of a cell that will control all the activities taking place inside the cell. That scientist is Robert Brown. And nucleus, it contains the small, minute, thread-like structures called chromosomes. Those chromosomes will be containing genetic material that will be transferring hereditary characters from a parent to the next new organism of their own kind. Means they are involved in the continuation of generation. And also, nucleus controls all the activities taking place inside the cell. And another scientist in the year 1839, scientist Purkinje, he discovered the liquid material inside the cell. That liquid material he named it as a protoplasm. Liquid-like material in the cell. So this was discovered by scientist Purkinje in the year 1839. So these all are scientists, they discovered the different components of the cell which are essential for all living organisms to survive. That cell will control all the activities inside the living organism. It may be a plant or an animal or bird or insect. When we see those are living organisms, those are made up of small minute things. So those minute things was discovered by Robert Hooke. But what are those minute things? Those are called as basic structural and functional unit. Why means all these are essential for maintenance of those living organisms for their survival purpose. So these are the fundamental units of a life, which will control all the activities of the living organism, and they also help in maintenance of the living organisms. Later, this cell, he defined the cell as a basic structural and functional unit. Similarly, when you see the house. You might have seen houses. So what are these houses made up of? House is made up of different rooms. And different rooms, each room when you see, that room is made up of walls. And when we look at walls of the houses, they are made up of small units called bricks. So similarly, when we compare house with our human body, is also made up of different organs. Each organ is made up of tissues, and each tissue is made up of a small unit